Hi everyone, and thank you for joining us today. My name is Malia, and I will be the host of today's webinar, Move from Document-Based Design Control and Risk Management to Improve Collaboration, Quality, and Delivery in Medical Device Development. Before we begin, we wanted to cover a few housekeeping items. At the bottom of your screen are multiple application engagement tools. Each of the tools are resizable and movable, so feel free to move them around to get the most out of your desktop space. You can expand your presentation area or maximize it to full screen by clicking on the arrows in the top right corner. If you have any questions during the webcast, you can submit them through the Q&A engagement tool. We will try to answer these during the webcast, but if an in-depth answer is needed or we run out of time, they'll be answered later in a follow-up email. Please know that we do capture all questions, so no questions will be left unanswered. Some networks cause slides to advance more slowly than others. So if your slides are behind, push F5 or Command R on your keyboard and it should refresh. You can find additional answers to some common technical issues located in the Help widget at the bottom of your screen. A copy of today's slide deck and additional helpful materials are available in the resource list. We encourage you to download any resources or links you may find useful. And lastly, this webinar will be recorded and sent via the email you registered by. It will also be available to watch on demand on JAMA's website. Now, allow me to introduce your speaker. Today, the Move from Document-Based Design Control and Risk Management webinar will be presented by Zeb Geary. Zeb brings over 15 years of experience in software consulting and business analysis to JAMA's enterprise customers and helps them deploy and optimize their use of the platform. Over the past 5.5 years, he's worked closely with many regulated customers, especially within the medical device industry, to provide best practices and deployment assistance to better align JAMA Connect to regulated activities pertaining to design control and verification. Before handing it off to Zeb, I wanted to remind you that we'll be answering questions via the Q&A widget you can find on the bottom of your screen. Following Zeb's demo will be a Q&A session where we hope to get through all of your questions. All right, Zeb, give us a breakdown of today's webinar.
Thanks, Malia. Hello, and thank you all for joining today. Really appreciate your time, and I hope that you find this webinar informative and useful. So today we're going to be holding up two very specific needs for medical device manufacturers and exploring how to harmonize two seemingly conflicting topics. Specifically, we'll be talking about documentation of design controls and risk, and the product definition and development processes and tools that drive and support that work. We'll look at challenges organizations face when the focus is on documentation, and we'll discuss how to support a shift in that focus. Lastly, we'll explore how the JAMA Connect for Medical Device Development solution can help teams bring these two needs together. And for that, we'll be jumping into JAMA itself. So to start, we'll ask a simple question that will help direct our discussion for today. And this is that question. So what is driving the way you work? And I'll pause just for a moment so you can check in with your own thoughts here before we dive into what we typically see as the answer. So if we consider two aspects of your work, the first being the processes and tools that define your methodology and support your work, and the second being the documentation generated to show compliance with applicable regulations and standards, what tends to drive your team? And although it is true that both are necessary, you may find that one carries more weight than the other. And for many medical device manufacturers, the answer has been to prioritize the documentation needs of the quality system, especially when considering regulated design control and risk management activities. And of course, this is understandable given that the documentation serves as the evidence that's needed to get a product cleared and into the market. But as we'll see, there are challenges teams face when documentation starts to tip the scale. And our assertion here at JAMA is that having to prioritize the documentation needs over the product definition and development process and tools is really unnecessary. In fact, many times what feels like a prioritization of the documents over all else is really just a symptom of using documentation tools like Word or Excel to manage product development activities. And we see this a lot. What tends to happen is the quality management system requires specific documents as evidence of proper design and development activities, and to show alignment with regulatory requirements. And working backwards from those quality needs results in the use of documentation tools to support the product development lifecycle. And this may work for a while, but often does not scale. Of course, the problem here is that the opportunity to improve processes and to increase efficiency and quality is not found in the documentation improvements. There isn't a better Word template or an Excel macro that can help. The opportunities to improve are in the product development processes and tools. And this is where teams gain value. So now that we've put the question out there and explored what is typically the choice teams are making, let's explore the challenge teams face. And the challenge as we see it is that teams are trying to balance the needs of meeting design control regulatory requirements with how they desire to work. And I call it specifically this idea of how teams desire to do work, because our customers are more often than not looking to modernize and see a lot of opportunities and new solutions and becoming more collaborative, really improving how they work. Design control and risk management activities and the resulting required artifacts are many times supported by existing document-centric processes and tools. And although they are difficult to work with, sometimes the confidence and the comfort in having them and not changing outweighs the benefits of modernizing through supporting tools and introducing change. However, we would argue that this comfort and confidence is really in perception only. Behind that perception is the reality of teams struggling with the need to align to market and user needs, deliver quickly to market, and build efficiencies into how they work together. All that while working to produce and maintain the necessary design control and risk-related artifacts. In essence, the issue is that how teams work and the documentation needs are seen as being at odds with one another, when in fact, that doesn't have to be the case. Beyond team members simply struggling to keep up with the documentation needs and create the trace matrix, there is real risk to quality and gaining clearance, especially as product complexity only increases. And while it may seem that the documents that go into submission, as long as they are polished in the end, should continue to be the focus, even more so as the docs and spreadsheets need to manage more information, there's clearly a tipping point. At some point, the ineffective and inefficient use of tools to manage everything becomes a risk in itself. Things get missed, precious time gets consumed, rework overwhelms innovation. Now, this is not to say that compliance-related design control and risk documentation is not important. It definitely is important, especially considering the regulations and requirements behind them. The intention here is not to suggest that the documentation is not significant. It's actually, we suggest that because of the significance, a keen focus on the work and the product development approaches from where these materials are generated will increase the confidence in the content in those materials, while at the same time opening the organization up to opportunities for efficiency and process improvements. And the complexity I mentioned is real. To take just a couple examples, here you can see the median number of years to reach the initial 510K clearance has increased from 3.5 years to just over 5 years, and that's between 2007 and 2013. And if that's not sign enough of increase in complexity, look to the increase in the number of pages in a 510K submission from 1983 to 2017. That is over a 2,000% increase. And consider this, that chart starts at 1983, and Microsoft Word, which many of the customers I work with are transitioning away from, was launched in 1983. And that's when the 510K averaged about 50 pages.